Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to create side-by-side two-column and three-column lists in Microsoft Word. We'll also look at how to reduce the space between the list columns. These steps are for bulleted lists and numbered lists. Today I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. This tutorial also applies to Word for Mac and the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2013. Before we begin, please note that these steps assume that you've already created your list. If you haven't done so already, please see my previous tutorials, How to Create Bulleted Lists in Microsoft Word, and How to Create Numbered Lists in Microsoft Word, both of which are linked below. To begin creating side-by-side lists, select the Home tab in the ribbon, and then select the Show Hide button to reveal your formatting marks. If there's no text after your list, place your cursor at the end of the final item, and then press the Enter key on a PC or Return key on a Mac to insert a paragraph break on the next line. If there's text after your list, this step is not necessary. Next, select the list. Be careful not to select any of the surrounding text or formatting marks. With the list selected, select the Layout tab in the ribbon. From there, select the Column button, and then choose two or three columns from the drop-down menu. The list should now appear as two or three side-by-side lists. You can now return to the Home tab and reselect the Show Hide button to hide your formatting marks. If your new side-by-side lists look too far apart, you can use the ruler to reduce the space between the columns. If your ruler isn't visible, select the View tab in the ribbon, and then select Ruler in the Show group. Next, place your cursor inside one of the list columns, and then hover your pointer over the left or right end of the white portion of the ruler. Your pointer should become a double-headed arrow. Slide the double-headed arrow towards the middle of the screen to drag your columns closer together. You may have to work from both ends of the ruler to get the placement just right. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, which offers my full collection of step-by-step Word tutorials. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.